I'm JRT, and here's a quick clip to show you some of the key fundamentals of hitting a bunker shot. Okay, recently I was in a tournament and my first round was completely ruined just because of one bad shot. And it came on the 16th hole in a bunker, the ball was slightly below my stance, and I made the mistake of gripping down on the grip. Okay, this took away length of the shaft, so the shaft was really short, and I didn't compensate by putting loads of knee flex in, and therefore coming through the ball, I didn't catch the sand, I caught the top of the ball, I caught it clean, and unfortunately OB was behind that pin and it went out of bounds. And that really ruined that first round for me, and it was just a simple mistake and a simple mental error for not remembering what I should be doing in a bunker. Okay, so what I really want to emphasize in this bunker session, this clip, is to grip up on the grip. Use the full length of the shaft on every single bunker shot, apart from the bunker shot where the ball is above your stance. If the ball's right up here and you're on a big slope, then yeah, grip down. But apart from that, always grip up, okay? Because it's going to ensure that you take sand, okay? And you're not going to have to do too much knee flex to compensate, okay? So bunker shots are really simple. We've got knee flex, we're keeping nice and still, head down, and we're gripping up on this shaft mainly. And distance wise, all we're doing is manipulating the club face. So if we've got a long bunker shot, we're keeping the club face square, and then we keep opening up, the shorter the shot gets and the higher we want to hit it. Okay, this shot in front of me, I've got about 30 yards to the front of the green. So I'm going to be opening up the club face about halfway. And I'm just going to show you here how to grip up on it and how it helps. Okay, so I'm going to set up to this ball. I'm going to open the club face halfway. I'm gripping up, taking my stance, and I'm staying dead still. See how it goes. Okay, I just lipped out. Okay, and the main thing was there that I caught the sand. Okay, I didn't have a shot which was gonna completely ruin my round. I mean, this is a par five. This is only, say, the fifth or the sixth, okay? So it's not a point in the round where I wanna be having a disastrous bunker shot. So I'm gonna show it one more time. Opening up, face halfway for this length shot, gripping up, taking my stance, setting it, hovering it above the ball, and then staying nice and still. Okay, lovely. So I've got two shots there within a good radius of the hole to hold them for birdie, okay? So just take that main tip on board about gripping up in the bunkers, just to ensure that you've got extra length on the shaft to catch the sand. And then you're never risking hitting the ball clean then and thinned, okay? So it's just about eliminating potential bad shots, okay? It's kind of damage limitation. You're preventing something from happening before it ever happens, okay? You know, it might be classed as a slightly negative way of thinking before a shot, but I find it helps if you can assess what could go wrong first and do whatever you can and do what people like me are saying and suggesting, which is going to prevent it, okay? So just take that tip on board about gripping up, have a go, see if it helps, and thank you for watching.
Your venom, keep it shut. I hate it when you hiss and preach about your new messiah, 'cause your theories catch fire. I can't find your silver lining. I don't mean to judge, but when you read your speech, it's tiring. Enough is enough. I'm covering my ears. when our worlds collide. I'm gonna drown you out before I lose my mind. I can't find your soul.